Hey guys, it's Bernband51 here with a free indie game gameplay commentary. Tonight we're playing a game called Bernband. It's a first-person exploration game. I don't know much about it, so let's just play it. Shoot. Already you can see this game is has some pretty cool lighting effects. It mixes some lo-fi graphics with some I guess you could say hi-fi effects and design qualities. Hey, what's up? I don't know, it looks pretty cool to me. Got some alien parties going on here. Yeah, unfortunately guys, I try to record my initial reactions to this gameplay and my recording software it didn't work quite right. So I'm kind of redoing it. So you guys aren't getting my initial response to this game, but that's not what matters. You guys get to see this cool game. Yeah, I was saying in my previous video, which got kind of messed up, while you can see the cars going through here, that these games like this with really lo-fi graphics that can combine them with newer modern gameplay elements and whatnot, it always provokes my imagination. Always seems like the coolest thing to me, because I don't know, something about it. Something like, you could have a game with really simple graphics, but you could have it play like Call of Duty 4. I mean, to me, like, fancy graphics are nice and whatnot, but after a while, whoa, what, how did, okay, anyway, that didn't happen the first time I played. Anyway, fancy graphics are nice, but after a while, you really, after a while of getting into the game and trying to get better at the game, you really, really don't care about the graphics. It's, just going in a circle. And I'm gonna fall down again. This game's cool. Little alien bathroom. Okay. I'm running. Walking. Running. Oh, I guess there's a little downhill slant here. That's interesting that it would do that. Where am I going? Where am I going? What's up, guys? Got a little TV going on there. Yeah, whoever did this, they put a lot of work, put their heart and souls into this game a little bit. A lot of good attention to detail for such a simple looking game. Here we are. We're in the tunnel here. I'll probably die if I jump down, but there's like a little door there. I'm gonna do it. I lived. I wonder what would happen if I actually got on one of those cars. Now, where does this go? Yeah, I wonder what graphics and I mean what game engine this was done in. I mean, it says really cool lighting and shadow effects, but it has just like the real thing. And okay, I don't know if I want to go in there yet. This looks like an important elevator. Let's see where this goes. Getting some weird music. Another elevator, some more stairs. Hey, on your cell phone? Beep boop, boop boop, beep boop. And I guess this is sort of like a subway. Oh, I can't actually run on the tracks. Huh. Interesting. Yeah, I remember the first time I played Super Mario. Like, when I was a little kid, when you're a little kid, you just want to explore everything. Whoa, there's actually a train coming. How cool is that? Wow, can I actually board it? I don't think I can. But this game surprised me before. I can jump. Can I jump into one of those spaces? Come on. Let me go. I want to get on the train. Oh. Can't read the sign. Sign doesn't matter. Signs don't matter. Anyway, I just really wanted to explore the world of the games I played when I was younger. Well, anyway guys, I think I'll end the video right here. The game's called Bernband. It's a really interesting game. I'll be putting the download link in the description so you guys can play it yourselves. Let me know what you guys think of the game in the comments. And I'm going to be doing some more free indie games every week, so don't forget to subscribe to see more of those. And yeah, I'll see you guys later.